and gentlemen, this is Anime Doodler, one of the many artists on MangaKollab.com, and today, me and a fellow member, Arrow, are going to be showing you not only how to draw a manga head, but also how to illustrate it in the program called Illustrator. Alright, without further ado, let's get started. First off, we should probably let you know that this is going to be a female character of mine called Lady Lass. Copyright, Anime Dealer, do not steal. Thank you very much. Okay, well, we're 30 seconds in, so let's get started with the actual drawing, shall we? Alright. First off, yes, you can still see me. Okay, we're going to start off with the head here. Circular. Next, draw the cheek area. Like this. Now, most anime girls have pointed chins. Guys actually have more rectangular ones. Just a little fun fact for you. Okay. Next is the ear. Like that. While I'm doing this part, Lady Lass' origins are actually, she was born in Scotland, but she was born in Ireland. What's the difference, you ask? I have no idea. They seem pretty similar to me. And I think I just offended most of the Irish and Scottish people out there. I'm very sorry. Alright, next off, we're gonna draw her neck. Do-do-do, this is fun, insulting races. Alright, next up is her eyes. Now, personally, I find eyes to be the very personality of an anime or a manga character, or any character in general, really. You can see a lot of stuff in eyes. They give a character most of their expression, and heck, they're just fun to draw once you get really good at it. You notice I'm adding these lash thingies here? That is because this is female, and usually when I draw female characters, they usually have eyelashes that are more visible than guys. I don't know why, it's just the rule of thumb, I suppose. Now, eyebrows. We're going to be kind of making her into a happy expression, I suppose. Yeah, it's a happy expression. Just going to erase some of the things I've drawn that are extras that I don't want. Next are the pupils. Now, anime girls tend to have larger eyes than the guys do. Again, don't ask me why, it just seems to be a rule of thumb. Something important you should probably keep in mind while I'm refilling my eraser here is that you always want to make sure that your eyes are pointed in the same direction. If not, your character looks stupid, and we don't want that. So it's a mistake I will constantly make, it's a mistake you will also possibly constantly make, but it's always really easy to fix. You can tell because, well, there's some space here, and there was no space there, so I'm going to have to fix that. Make sure there's a little bit of space. There, that's better, I suppose. There we go. Now we have the glare for the cartoony effect. Like that. There we go. And we just continue on like that. Now I'm starting to notice her eyebrows are a little askew. That's not good. So I'm going to fix that now. There we go. She's looking pretty good now. Okay, as I was saying about her origins while I'm doing the nose here and stuff, she's actually a bounty hunter, and she's got sort of a Trigun Cowboy Bebop thing going on. I was really obsessed with these two shows while I was creating this character, and essentially she is a bounty hunter, hence the Cowboy Bebop reference, and she refuses to kill anyone if she can help it, which is the Trigun reference. If you haven't seen either of those two shows, what the heck's wrong with you? Go see them after you finish rating this video 5 stars. Blatant advertising is blatant and fun. Alright. When you get more experience with your drawings, you see what works and what doesn't. You can see a lot of little things that just don't seem quite right in your art. I'm noticing a couple of them now, hence the constant erasing of such. Here, let me set this better so you can actually see what I'm talking about here. There we go. So don't be afraid to change something, realize you don't like it, and then go back, because that is a perfectly normal way of doing this entire thing we call art, or manga, more specifically. Okay, now we're going to do her hair. It parts to the side here. And it kind of goes over her ears like that. There we go. I actually remember, last summer is when I invented this character. Go figure for that one. But it was actually last year I invented this character, and I wasn't that good at drawing. I mean, I was better than some and really good compared to most, but I wasn't great, and I still don't think I'm great, but I definitely think I'm better off than where I was then. To show you what I mean, I'll probably manage to pull up something. I think I still have the original drawing here around here somewhere. But I'll see if I can hunt up a picture of the old lady lass and show you what I mean when I say you can improve. Because the Lord knows I certainly have. Anyway, we're almost done here. Lady lass has this necklace that was actually given to her by her dad. Now, she doesn't particularly like her dad and she thinks he is a scummy slime ball. But you know, she can't really take it off. It's the one way her father's able to track her and, you know, maintain that she doesn't really disobey him in anything. Yeah, her father's kind of a... I think I just censored myself. Okay, anyway. Right now I'm trying to work with Lady Lass's hair here, as you can see. She has this kind of odd hairstyle where it sort of goes this way. It's really weird. I think it was something to do with all the hills she stood on as a kid. You know, Ireland, windy, so. I think her hair just sort of grew like that. I'm not really sure. I'm going to have to look into that a little bit further. But I'm giving you the basic character stuff. Because this is my character. Eric will probably go more into the details of how what makes a face work and what makes eyes work and all that good stuff. But I'm just going to concentrate on character development and stuff like that because this is my character. And I gotta say, I'm pretty partial to her. Alright, looks like we're almost done. At this point in the process, you just want to kind of touch up a bit. Get rid of any lines that could be distracting to the overall image. So that includes, like, the base of the skull we drew earlier. There we go. Add little touches like shadows. Like that. And then give her a shirt there. Here, let me show you. There we go. Give her a shirt there. That is a horrible whistle, in case you did not know. Alright then. And that, ladies and gentlemen, on here, is a finished Lady Lass. Now, Arrow, take it away! I'm gonna go